All right, for the first time since 1997, the newly reconstituted Russell 3000 will have a market cap of less than $11 trillion. The almost month-long process of reconstituting the Russell indexes will be finalized today after the close. Stephen Wood is chief market strategist at Russell Investments. He joins us now to discuss some of the highlights. Thanks for coming to the show. Steve, let me ask you first what the biggest changes are. What are the major changes here?
I think the biggest change is going to be the drop in market cap. Whether you're looking at the United States or you're looking at globally, you're just seeing an indiscriminate sell-off. So I think for a lot of the rebalancing issues and the reconstitution issues, I think probably one of the biggest themes is going to be how broad-based this sell-off was. You mentioned that the Russell 3000, which is the broadest measure of, you know, the investable U.S. market, fell from over 16.5 trillion to just over 10.5 trillion. That's a big drop. Also, globally, you're seeing 51 trillion go down to about 31. So this is pretty broad based.
So it's first of all, tell us why you decided to do this here.
The
rebalancing.
The reconstitution takes place every year.
Right.
Every year we come in end of May through the end of June, and we reconstitute the index to make sure, based upon the rules-based methodology, market cap, that we get the most consistently accurate representation of large cap, small cap, and the broader market. So this is an annualized process that's been going on for almost three decades.
And what do you see as far as the changes for sectors here?
I think probably the thing that's going to get a lot of people's attention is that in large cap space anyway, technology is now the largest sector, and financials has dropped from number one to number two. So that probably won't surprise anybody, but they're probably going to take note on that. But that being said, in large cap space, financials are still the number two in terms of capitalization. But in smaller cap, the Russell 2000, financials are still by far, you know, the largest sector weight, with technology coming in second. So that's probably the biggest sector shifts we've seen.
What does that mean as far as how the indexes reflect what's going on in the economy?
Well, what you see is if you get too small to be in the 1,000, you drop into the 2. So a lot of the names that are coming into the 2 are financials, which obviously got hit disproportionately along with some commodities and materials over those last years. So you're seeing names come down, and that large market cap kind of pushed everything down by magnitude. So some of those microcap names are kind of bleeding into the Russell 2000 as well.
All right, let's talk about what you see going on in the economy and the markets here. A lot of people have been talking about a correction, a summer lull, Steve Krall has said. Do you feel that, like, we're turning around here, turning back around?
In terms of going up, I think the economy is doing okay.
No, I mean the market in terms of going back down after the big rally that we've had since the March lows.
Yeah, I think it's maybe there's some profit-taking going. We got some window dressing. It's quarter end. I think a year and a half ago, you had an equity market priced for absolute perfection coming into the end of 2007. You know, coming into March of this year, you had a market price for the apocalypse. And now we've kind of reverted back to something in between. So I think we've run out of fantastic reasons to sell everything. But now I think from this point, the market's looking at for justifications to buy. And I think that's going to be a slower process. I think it's going to be an actively managed process. And I think there's going to be big differences between names going forward. Strong balance sheets, low debt positions, you know, grabbing market share, putting your competitors out of business. I think those companies should do well. So I'm not as convinced it's going to be a broad participation as much as great companies ought to do better, and investors should look for that.
So stock picking going forward, what are you looking for, though, that... You know, what signs do you look for that we actually do pick up in this economy?
Well, I think we want to look at the jobless numbers, real-time indicator claims. I think what we saw on durable goods was not bad news a few days ago. So I think you're making an okay argument. We're not out of the recession yet. I think the data are going to turn around fourth quarter this year. So I would think the most likely scenario, the U.S. exits the recession fourth quarter this year. I think we'll find that China is already growing. Europe will lag into 2010. So right around here, I think the market is going to have to sort through a lot of complicated details on what to buy going into 2010. But corporate bond space, I think a lot of people want to take a look at that as well.
All right. Thanks very much, Steve, for joining us. Stephen Wood there from Russell Investments.